Flynn, four games to go, nearly at the end of your first season as a Swansea player. How happy have you been with the way things have gone?
Yeah, very happy. Obviously, we would like to have got playoffs and got promoted and whatnot. But like, it's a year of transition. And I think the last few games, you can really see that it is starting to like really kick in. The boys are putting on really good performances. So that's exciting for next year. And yeah, personally, I think it's gone well. I've played quite a lot of games. The gaffer's helped me a lot with the positioning and that side of things. And yeah, I really enjoyed it. Really enjoyed it.
We've talked before, haven't we, about how before you came here in exile, really, at Ipswich. I mean, you must be very happy stepping up to the Championship and becoming a mainstay of this team.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, I'm more than happy. Obviously, Ipswich, it was a bit of a... It was a tough time. Position playing 23s, and obviously to come here, but yeah, that's I can't thank Gaffer enough for that. He put a lot of trust in me, and he believed in me, and yeah, that's why when I got out there on a Saturday, I'll just try and prove to everyone that I can do it, and I obviously just want the team to win and perform well, and yeah, that's what I try and do every Saturday.
You touched on it there. How much has the team progressed, do you think, since the early stages of the season where you had some struggles, didn't you, at times? Even the first half of the season, really, consistency was an issue, wasn't it? But now, as the season draws to a close, you are finding that consistency.
Yeah, I think early doors, it was... We was playing some good stuff, but we just couldn't find the end product and stuff like that. It just wasn't really clicking. Like there was something missing. But now I think we're starting to really do it all. We're keeping a lot of clean sheets, scoring a lot of goals now, dominating the ball pretty much every game. It's really enjoyable to play in, and it's really clicked lately. But that was the thing at the start. It was a year of transition. So I think obviously we're not going to overlook the last four games, but I think next year is really, really promising.
That was going to be my next question. How excited are you about the prospects for next year and what you might achieve based on the progress you made this year?
More than excited. I think, yeah, from what we've done this year, I think if you just give us a bit more time, obviously have a pre-season together. Like, most of these boys haven't even had a full pre-season. Like, hardly any of them have. So I think if we have a full pre-season, I think it could be scary.
What do you think? It's a long way off, isn't it? We've got to see what happens in the summer, but... As it stands, what do you think your hopes will be, your targets come the start of next season as a club?
Win the league. Just put it out there. Why not? I think this year, I suppose when I go into a game, and I think I'm talking on behalf of all the boys here, there's not one team that we play and think, God. Do you know what I mean? So I don't get how next year when we've had more time, I could just see us going into every game thinking, right, let's win this one then. Do you know what I mean? And being fully confident that we're going to win the game. I think win the league, promotion, definitely.
Not asking for much then, Flynn.
Nah, not much. Not much. No, you got aim high, ain't you?
Yeah.
So.
And it'll be important what the club does in the summer, I guess, to keep that momentum going. You know, you'll be hoping that none of your key players depart and maybe one or two new faces come in.
Yeah, definitely. Because that's like every team wants to strengthen. Hopefully we'll do that next year. I suppose I'll just leave that stuff to the boss. Yeah. It is exciting. If we do strengthen, then yeah, we'll see what happens.
What about you, Flynn? Your performances this season have already led to some speculation about the possibility of you attracting some interest in the transfer window. What have you made of that?
Yeah, to be honest, I don't really take the notice of it. I know every player says the same, but I actually haven't. When I was at Ipswich, I'd done that. I think I took a lot of notice of what was going on. And I've really learned from that. And I said to myself last time, I wouldn't be like that again. So I've sort of just, I'm just carrying on doing what I do. I've gone straight to my football, really.
I think Kieran Dyer was in one of the papers in Ipswich saying you're going to move for $10 million this summer.
Yeah, someone sent me that. Someone did send me that. But yeah, no, look, it's football at the end of the day. Like, anything can happen, but I love it here, to be honest. I'm really happy. I think next year, we've got high hopes. So yeah, I'm just looking forward to that, really. I'm not really thinking about anything else.
Because there's been, I mean, I'm sure you've heard, there's been links with Leeds United in some of the papers.
Yeah.
Any young player like you would want to play at the top level, I'm sure, at some stage.
Yeah. Yeah, no, look, that's always been my dream. I've always said I want to play in the Premier League. That's one thing I really want to do. But, yeah, I suppose that, like, I know the money changes when you're in the Premier League and all this stuff, but there's more to life than money. I've really learned that lately. And I'm really happy here. Like, just bought a house down here, all that stuff, like, just been getting all settled. It's been stressful, to be honest, but got there in the end. And yeah, like, there's more to life than money, do you know what I mean? So I'm loving my football down here. I love everything about this place, the staff, the players, the whole area. So yeah, I'm happy, and that's all it is, really.
And from what you're talking about, obviously the two things go together. You want to play in the Premier League, and you're saying next year you believe you can have a real good go at it. So you know, conceivably you can achieve your target in a Swansea shirt.
Yeah, hopefully. And I really do believe that. Like, that's not me just coming in here saying, oh yeah, I think we can get promoted, all this. I really do believe we can, like, we will. So yeah. Yeah, happy days, really, innit?
Well, let's hope it happens. And just going back to this season, four games left, as we said. Middlesbrough next. Again, you're playing a team with, you know, more to play for than you. But you'll be hoping to keep this unbeaten run going.
Yeah, definitely. I think we can build a bit of momentum as well going into next year. I think we can set a little marker with the next four teams if we win all four, whatever. I think teams will really start to fear us for next year. And that's got to be our game plan, do you know what I mean? We've got to go out there these last four games. I know other teams have got more to play for or whatever. But, yeah, look, we've just got to go out there and try and put a marker down for next year, really.
And just one thing I should ask you about, Flynn, you've had some trouble with your knee. Is it your knee lately?
Yeah.
Are you okay? Just tell us about that.
Yeah, I'm fine. I had a little niggle in the Cardiff game. Stiffened up, whatever. And then I had a tiny little setback. To be fair, I pushed it a bit too early. I had a little setback. And then, yeah, it's fine now. Absolutely fine. I was blind a bit on Saturday, I'll be honest. The fitness weren't all there. But no, I feel good. So hopefully the fitness can get a bit in today and look good for Saturday.
Great stuff. Thanks, Flynn.
Lovely. Thank you.